Hello, I apologize greatly for sorry what I said in my past video. This is exactly where the enemy of religions, enemy of humanity, enemy of Shia Islam, enemy of Wahhabi Islam, any kind of Islam. To corrupt Islam and then to ignite a fire amongst Muslims. So there's no way that my mad desire should come. This is a talk to myself too. So please try to understand. You see, all this is going on. To make us angry at Iran, at Saudi Arabia too. And this is not at all what Imam Hussein alayhi salam or even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would want. What Maula Hassan did was a peace treaty with Muawiyah. That's how we should keep quiet. Imam Ali alayhis salam kept quiet for 30 years, my father told me. I think around 30 years. So please, also Shia Muslims in majlises, if you hear anything against Saudi Arabians from our mullahs, Shia alims, maulanas, overlook that. Completely overlook that. I went to the Facebook profile page of King Abdullah of Saudi Arabia and gave something there, shared something there. He never took action against me. So as I'm telling myself and trying to calm myself down, and seeing the conspiracy of the enemy. So please, whether it comes from Iran or our Shia Maulanas, Alims, totally overlook it. Jesus Christ says, love your enemies. Imam Hussein alayhi salam gave his infant son, Bibi Zainab, Salamullah Alayha, gave her two children. So we are not going to make our majlises, azadaris, a battlefield. And I have to say this because there was someone I know sharing wrong information about Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia and rejoicing that he is dead. But thank God he's alive and that news was wrong. I know that in my strength, I've never wished death for my enemies. And only the weak people do this and rejoice in the death of an enemy. Strong people, great people, don't do this. This is a really evil time. I don't want to scare you or myself. Well, I am scared, very much worried and scared. And because there's an energy on me too that I can't avoid. But still, I have to tell myself and correct myself. This madness must stop. I'm struggling, trying my best, and to avoid these Saudi Arabia and Iran thing going on. Totally avoid it. It is best for us that we, great people, make peace. And yes, even Hazrat Musa alayhi salam was asked to go to Fir'aun and gently speak to him. So that's how the Shias of Imam Ali are. And because they have the power now, the enemy has given Iran and Saudi Arabia, both, the power. If they want, they can destroy the world. And it's all due to the enemy of Islam and Muslims. And this has been ongoing. It was a plan long ago planned. So please avoid any mullah, alim, who says things against Saudi Arabia or ignites a fire against America. There are Shia Muslims in the United States of America too, and they are quiet. So like in the Karachi American School, they tried to provoke me once, twice, and thrice they won. And even though they're trying to come after us, destroy us, they cannot destroy the truth. Imam Hussein's sacrifice is unparalleled in the whole history of mankind, even in present times. I know you may think this is cowardliness or hypocrisy from my side. I'm also questioning this. Imam Ali stayed quiet silent for 30 years. And I remember, may I say this in Urdu, we always believed, agar dushman bhi ghar pe aaye na, to unko sahi tarah milna hai. But you know what happened to me was that I was in this madness, energy driving me nuts and keeping my thoughts compulsively on one thing and torture. So a friend of mine wanted to come over to see me, and I didn't want to see her because I was in this really mad, weak state. So I was trying to avoid her. Agar wo ghar aa jaati na, if she comes to my place, then I have to meet her like a friend and keep my heart clean. And no word that would hurt her heart, which was very difficult for me to do. And so that's why many things like this, I requested my friend not to come over, because I was not in the condition, a normal condition, to see her. And this would be against my belief, my principles, humanity, that someone, agar dushman bhi ghar aaye, to usko bezat bilkul nahi karna hai. Aur agar koi peacefully aata hai, to then there is no way we should say anything or act in any manner that disrupts the peace plans of the person, the peaceful ways. Dekhen, dushman bahut chalaki se andar aa gaye hain aur hamare imam bargah mein aa gaye hain, hamare Shia Islam mein aa gaye hain. Bare bare scholars aa gaye hain, par ke aa gaye hain, ilm hasil karke aa gaye hain. To meharbani se aap log sab, khuda aapko sabr de, mujhe bhi de, aur hame sab inshallah insaniyat, sacha Islam establish karne ki quwwat de. إن شاء الله. إلهي آمين. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. Please pray for me too. Thank you so much.